Well, I just received a Mongoose Hitch. FedEx delivered it just a minute ago, and I unboxed it and put it up on the park stand here. I'll give you some info on the bike here. This bike is going to be converted to a e-bike with a big BBSHD Luna drive. Oh, my buddy's here to help. Okay. First comment is, came in a monster box and it was packed extremely well. All this stuff you see on the floor right here was wrapped around the tubes, and they did an excellent job of securing everything. These are all monster wire ties. Nothing was moving around. Nothing was dented, damaged. It was excellent. I already removed a bunch of reflectors and some of these are the plastic units that were on the axle end of the axles. Let me give you a little tour of the bike here first. This freaking monster. It's got a 7-speed freewheel in the back. It's got a pretty beefy looking KMC chain. It's got a Shimano tourney derailleur. And I don't know what the crank is. It's got some flat pedals. Crank's going to be discarded here once the motor kit goes on it. Let's go up here. Maybe I'll go around the other side. We got a bright light on the back side of this. Let's do the seat here first. It's got a big heavy steel seat post that is 28.6 in diameter and a big heavy seat, and it doesn't have a removable clamp for the seat post. It's got the bolt with the quick release, so you can't put a regular clamp on this frame here, but that's no big deal. I don't really move the seat that much anyways, and it's going to be clamped down tight. Let's go around the other side here. Get that bright light out of the way there. Go up front here. Got some cheap steel bars and a cheap stem. Cheap brakes. Cheap headset. But the bike was like $289. With shipping, it was $293 from Walmart. Actually, shipping was zero. With tax, it was $293. I chose to have it delivered to the store, but to my surprise, FedEx delivered it right to my house. I thought I was going to have to go to the Walmart and pick it up. It's got 160 millimeter rotors and cheap mechanical brakes, 4-inch tires, rims appear to be steel. They have cutouts in the middle. It's got a kickstand, which I may leave on for now, but I've seen some big double kickstands that can secure a big heavy bike better than this. But like I said, this whole bottom bracket crank assembly goes when the motor comes. Go around the back. All right. Let me see. I didn't name what kind of tires come with this thing here. I don't even... Where's the writing at here? 26 by 4.0. Kind of hard to see here. CHAO Yang. Chow Yang. Maximum inflate 20 psi. Yeah, right. This will be a 7 to 10 psi. But anyways, actually, I have been doing bike repair stuff for many, many, many years, and I just went through my drawer of parts here and I found a bunch of really super light replacements that I already had, already paid for, that I don't have to buy extra parts for this. Found a specialized bottle cage. I don't know if it'll fit properly after the battery goes on the frame for the motor drive. Nice race face seat post. But this is a 27.2 and it's a 28.6. So I ordered a shim 27.2 to 28.6 so I can use this seat post, because it's really a nice seat post and I'll never use it. Reason being, over there there's two carbon fiber bikes, and everything on those bikes is all carbon fiber seat post, handlebars, everything. And I ride Speed Play Frogs since the 90s. Both those bikes I just showed you have frogs on them. But I found another pair in a drawer, because I like to ride clipless. I like to ride clipped in. This is a carbon bar and stem that I ordered, but I didn't like it on my gravel bike, my carbon gravel bike. So I had a Thompson already, and Easton bars that I like better. So this is like weighs nothing. I'm going to do a before and after weight comparison after I put this lighter stuff on here. Now, the steel headset was already mentioned by Cheap Bikes. I'm going to have to get the link down for the guy. He did a bunch of great videos on this Mongoose bike, and based on his advice and looking at the stock headset, I just went ahead and ordered this FSA Fat Pig. They're cheap. They're like 20, low 20 something dollars, and the bearings are way nicer. And I have this super lightweight Yeti saddle from one of my Yetis, WTB saddle. And I actually could even, there's 160 millimeter rotors on this bike. I will be going to some hydraulics, but I wanted to wait till the bike got here so I could measure how long the rear line is going back there, because the brake set I'm looking at gives two options for a longer rear brake line. So I'll be measuring that, but I have all these rotors left over here from years. I could actually even put these big 200 millimeter rotors on that thing with hydraulics when I get done there. So, you come to help? Yeah. So that's the starting point. I'm going to weigh the thing in a minute here, and then that'll get added to this video here, because I'm going to do a before and after I put all the lighter weight, better quality parts that I have sitting here. Anyways, I ordered a Luna BBSHD 1000 watt motor kit from Luna Cycles, with all the bells and whistles. And the reason I started with this cheap bike is because if I like this fat bike as a e-bike and I really enjoy it, I will just remove the motor kit and I will build a full carbon fat bike. And also, I forgot to mention, I'm going to weigh these wheels here, but it's real easy to go tubeless on big fat wheels like this, because all my bikes over there are all tubeless with stands in it. So that's going to be a before and after weight on this also. While I have it apart, I'm going to weigh these tires separate from the wheel there, just so I know how much these tires weigh. But I think they'll be just fine for now. They look like they roll good. This bike is not for hardcore trail use, because here in Pisgah Forest, there are no e-bike signs on most of the single track trails. But there's plenty of gravel roads and logging roads and grassy roads that you can ride on also. So that's the main plan for this, because I have those super light carbon bikes over there for off-road use and gravel bike use. But this should be a really fun project, and I'll have more videos after this when I start the motor build.